Yeah, I know. That's the kind of clown this guy is. He won't even pay to have real cards made.
Yeah, really? Because I've emailed them about a million times each. Hired's online all day long. No, I always left messages and spoke to them when they called me back. Yes? Yeah, definitely.
It did. That was added by the copy desk during
it. Was the hack?
No, that part of the article is misleading. I was never in the Restles' home at all.
No, I didn't mean to imply that I had been.
Sorry about that. Did the facts come through okay?
Okay, you want to read it back to me?
Wait. Was that an M? After juked, was that an M, as in Micronics?
Try M.
I have no idea. I don't have a website, so I don't really know that much about them. I would trust you guys to know better than me. Hey, do you guys still want that number for Jim Gort? Because I just found it in my notes. All right, 605-84...
Oh, sorry.
Oh. I guess I got him mixed up with another source. Sorry about that one. Oh, you know what it was? Jim Gort was actually the guy who told me about the law enforcement officials. I don't know what I was thinking. I'm gonna have to get you that.
Are we off the record?
Well, off the record, some of the things that you've brought up, the website, the idea that I was always speaking to these people through voicemail, that is, that they were always calling me. It didn't seem strange before, but clearly there are some problems with the story. You've pointed them out.
One portion of it was structured in a way that...
In light of all this... I'm increasingly beginning to believe that I've been duped.
And so we hang up after he's basically let these guys interrogate me for an hour. And I go, Chuck, what happened? I mean, why didn't you back me up? He goes, I'm sorry, Steve. I gotta protect the magazine. I mean, I'm the editor. It's being such an asshole. So I'm dead, pretty much.
Yeah, I know. I really gotta quit. You were right.
What about?
What for?
I already told you. Nobody knows where he is.
And Chuck, we'll have there some clues how to find him.
Hundreds of people there, okay?
They're so highly suspicious, you know? About some...
Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, I'll get my notes. Let's go.
You're at this table. Restle sat here, his mother was on his left. His mother was on his right. Hyatt sat there, but then Restle wanted him closer, so he slid his chair over. Sim sat here, he had a lawyer next to him. I forget the guy's name, it's in my notes. Somebody was smoking at this table, so then Restle's mother insisted that we move to one farther away. Over there. Yeah, the building next door. Looked like 100, it might have been 2, it's in my notes. Yeah, they moved in and out. I mean, most of them were kids. All I know is I was here. All of us were right here. Yes, we're sure. All I know is I was here. The conference was right here. That's why the Restles only stayed a few minutes, okay? Because it was such a dumb place to squeeze into. So they went to a restaurant for dinner with some of Ian's hacker friends. Huh? About 10, I think. Including me. Ian even put on a jacket. Yeah. Yeah, it's across the street. You know, I really don't like the way you're treating me, Chuck. It's like you won't even talk to me. Yes. I didn't do anything wrong, okay? I didn't do anything wrong. You saw my notes. Everything was in there. I got tricked. I got fooled. I'm sorry. What are you being so mad for? Yes. Yes. Yeah, I know. I know. They almost didn't let us in. Okay, but it was a couple of minutes before 3, and Ian looked like he was about ready to cry, and so they said, okay, go in and ask him yourself, Chuck. Okay, go in and see if they would serve a party that came in at 2:58, and the answer would be yes, because that's when we got here.
They're gonna dig through the records and that off them.
I didn't do anything wrong, Chuck. You know, this is not right, Chuck. Okay, I feel really attacked. And you're my editor, you're supposed to support me, and you're taking their word against mine? You're supposed to support me!
I'm sorry I yelled at you back there. Chuck?
There's been so much pressure. Hey, Chuck, I didn't mean to get anybody in trouble.
No. You know, I had a description of it from so many sources. I thought I had it solid, okay? And I wanted the piece to have an eyewitness feel to it for color, so... is that I've been there myself. I'm so sorry, Chuck. I just panicked. If you want me to say that I made it up, I will. If that'll help you, I'll say it. I'm so dead. I mean, I'm over. Nobody's ever gonna hire me again, are they? I was so sloppy trusting my sources like that. And then lying about it. And to Chuck, of all people, I mean, the one guy who's hated me all along. No, Chuck keeps a list in his head. Everybody who's a Michael Kelly person. A couple of times, I said some things I shouldn't have said about you. So now I'm on it. That's why he's so set on killing me now. I know, I'm not saying that they weren't. I did some terrible, terrible things. But believe me, Michael, Chuck doesn't care about any of it. It's my loyalty to you that he's punishing me for. I'm such an idiot. Now who's gonna hire me?
What?
No, Sims is a real guy. I've talked to him a million times, Chuck. My brother and I aren't even speaking right now.
Stop.
You don't
know. Website, all those voicemails.
You've got this totally
backwards.
I don't know what you're talking about, okay? Those are all real people. Yeah. Those are all real people. What? There's some files, okay? I have to put them on a disc. No, they're mine. Personal stuff. I know you don't. And at least shut down my computer. I'm in the middle of a file, Chuck. God damn it. Jesus Christ. Can I take my Rolodex? Can I take my law books? I'm not a criminal, Chuck. Okay? I'm not a criminal.
Chuck.
I said I was sorry. Chuck. The thing with George Sims, that was the voice that you heard on the telephone. That was my brother. I'm sorry. There really is a George Sims. I've spoken to him a million times. He just stopped talking to me, you know, because of the article. He was so mad about it. I didn't know what to do. And the guys from Forbes were putting so much pressure on me, you know, and you were so mad. I just thought that if I could get everybody off my back, okay, for just a day would give me enough time to go and find him. You can understand that, can't you? What? But you can't. Chuck, will you please take me to the airport? Please, okay? You don't have to talk to me if you don't want to. It's fine. But I can't be by myself right now, okay? I'm afraid of what I'm gonna do. You know, I can't get there by myself. But I'm afraid that I'm gonna do something, okay? Did you hear what I said? Chuck, please?
Okay. Yeah? I suppose I could. Thanks. You have to know who you're writing for, and you have to know what you're good at. I record what people do. I find out what moves them, what scares them, and I write that down. That way they're the ones telling the story. And you know what? Those kind of pieces can win Pulitzers too.